All right, eighth place, another fan favorite, Victor Martinez. I will start off this segment with Victor Martinez saying there's no way this man should have placed higher than Steve Kuklo. Now, listen, I know Victor's, he's older, he's been in the game for a while. Maybe he's earned a lot of respect with the judges. He's got to have. He remains a constant threat, literally in the top 10 of the Mr. Olympia, and has been. I feel like his great shape carries him. He's got very round muscle bellies, that usually carries him. He does have great size, and he does come in very, very full. Not a very vascular athlete, and I also feel like he's got like smaller arms than a lot of other athletes in this lineup, mainly in the tricep area. But to be honest with you, look how round he is. I mean, everything's just very round, very good round muscle bellies. Now check this out. Here's another guy with very, very high calves. If you look at this next shot here, high calves, super big, freaky big adductors that almost, honestly, they almost kind of dwarf the rest of his leg development. You can see that he has super round, I almost want to say unnaturally round biceps. Like, I mean, his biceps are freaking like softballs. They're just so dang round. And you can definitely see he's got smaller triceps. Waist is big and blocky and wide. Let's move on. All right, next shot. Super, super thick legs. You can see that. All right, I'm not hiding that. I will be the first to say Victor Martinez has some thick, full legs. Definitely a good shot for Victor, showing literally his overall mass that he carries to the Mr. Olympia stage. All right, next shot. This shot is terrible. It's terrible, man. Is out of control. All right, the abs are all types out of control. I mean, his obliques, they look very lean to me. They look ripped, shredded, whatever word you want to say, but that gut is huge. It's huge. I mean, the legs, also, his legs are thick. I've said it over and over, but there's not a whole lot of separation. And really, just the adductors just take away from the rest of his legs. All right, next shot. Listen, so far, everything we know about Victor thus far is this guy's round and full. He looks very dense here, very dense. His back is very dense, but his lower back, you can see right there, conditioning wise, it seems like it's holding a lot of water. It really does. He's got small calves, very small calves, obviously very high calves. Another athlete with just major missing pieces to his lower lats. Can you see as I go through this judging, if you will, of Victor Martinez, why he probably shouldn't have placed higher than Steve Kuklo? I don't know. That's none of my business. Last shot, great shot, but overall, again, this shot still does not do justice to the fact that Kuklo should have beat Victor Martinez. Okay, seventh place, Big Ramy. I know a lot of you guys have really been waiting to hear what I had to say about Big Ramy. And to be honest with you, take a look at this picture here. I have a lot to say about Big Ramy. Did I think Big Ramy got ripped off? I'm gonna say no. I think he and Branch should have definitely placed higher than Dexter Jackson, but I'm not gonna say he got ripped off. I'm not gonna take it that far. Here's what I want to say. I think he out-muscles everybody. He out-muscles Kai Greene. He out-muscles Phil Heath. He pretty much out-muscles everybody. Maybe with the exception of Rolly Winkler, who just came in so huge. But, I mean, he's massive. He's filled to the brim. The guy is completely full, totally filled up. He's got great muscle shape. He's got a tight waist in all his shots. I will go as far as to say he has a Mr. Olympia physique, but he's inconsistent. His calves are very small. They do not match his quads. He's soft from the rear. I would almost say, not 100%, but I would almost say his legs do not match the rest of his body. Now check it out. I'm all about big legs. All about big legs. But his are so big that they're almost not proportionate with the rest of his physique. They actually throw off his aesthetics and balance. Now, Rami did come in a lot tighter this year as opposed to last year, but he didn't come with the type of conditioning that moved the judges to place him higher. All right, moving on, this second shot. Now, I will say, man, for a big man to have a waist this tight is very impressive. It's very notable. He's kind of watery, man. He's kind of blurry. His obliques are not as dry and crisp. His abs look like they're holding water. Look at these legs. Look at these quads, okay? I'm not the only one that says this. His legs are just so big. Again, I'm all about big legs. I'm a leg dude. I'm all about leg day. Big legs, big legs. But his legs literally are so big that they almost look fake. Yes, I said that. His quads almost look fake. Just being honest, that's just my two cents, just a totally unbiased opinion. All right, next shot, check this out. Good pose for Rami, good pose, right? Hamstrings tied right into the glutes, but at this point you can start and begin to see a lack of sharpness in his physique. So, moving on, I will say right now, this is one of Rami's best poses minus the calves. From this shot, this front double bicep shot, I will say it is the best front double bicep shot in Mr. Olympia. It is, it's the best shot in Mr. Olympia. You can tell he really worked hard to bring that waist in. In this shot, I would almost say his legs are start to look like they match a little bit more with his upper body. 100% best shot for Rami. He destroyed Phil Heath in this. He destroyed Kai Greene in this. I wouldn't say he utterly destroyed Dennis Wolf in this, but he beat Dennis Wolf in this shot. Okay, so let's turn Rami around. Let's take a look at this man's back. Rami has the biggest rear lat spread of the entire Mr. Olympia. The biggest. It's huge. It's thick. He's got the classic V taper, as massive as it is. He does have a sick V taper from probably from every angle, one of the best backs in Mr. Olympia. But you can clearly see that from this shot, from the back, from the rear, you can see the major, and I will use major, lack of conditioning and dryness from the waist down in comparison to everybody else that placed higher than him. I would actually say moving forward in the Mr. Olympia, everyone else blew him away in conditioning and being dialed in. His calves are very, very underdeveloped. I think that his size really carried him thus far, but that conditioning just wasn't enough in the judges' eyes to put him ahead. Now, personally, me, I would have put Rami and Branch higher than Dexter because, yes, Dexter was more conditioned, but I think the conditioning that Dexter had, I don't think it's enough to make up the difference in mass with Branch and Rami. Okay, let's look at this last pose. This is actually the sixth pose I'm gonna talk to you about with Rami. The shape's there, the size is there, but very obvious right here, this is not a very grainy shot. This does not look like a grainy granite shot. It almost looks like he's holding a lot of fat in his glutes. The lower part itself is of his back is just a perfect indicator that he's not dialed in. Do I think Rami is a threat? Man, he is a threat. He is a threat. He's got everything he needs minus conditioning to place in the top three of the Mr. Olympia. I hope Dennis Wolf, I hope Kai Greene, and I hope Phil Heath, shoot, I hope everybody takes note of Rami and work their butt off to make sure and ensure that they're gonna be able to beat this man next year.